Hello everyone, my name is Jenny, and today's presentation is about visualizing and making data interactive. With our final week coming in very close, hopefully we've thought about our next steps in terms of courses we'll take in the next semester. Like, what courses should I take next semester? When will I graduate? Am I even gonna graduate? These questions are what all university students have asked themselves at least once, including me. And asking these questions are good, but when we actually need to plan out our degree, that's when it gets a little bit overwhelming. So MacEwan has made efforts to try and seize this problem of the planning just being inefficient in general. And today, I'm just going to talk really quick about three ways before I get into my demo of how to plan a MacEwan degree. And this is to give context on how complex it could be to plan your degree and why we need a solution for this. The first way to plan is using the MacEwan degree planning sheets, which I asked last time. And some of you, most of you guys, haven't used it yet, or have only seen it, or have never seen it before. And that's probably because nobody wants to plan by paper, especially when it comes to keeping track of everything and it's always changing. So paper is probably not the best way to plan your MacEwan degree. So let's move to a little bit more efficient way to plan. Crossover between paper, your own made checklist. But here's the problem with that. Say you made your own checklist, you wrote it down, you listed all the courses that you need to take, but now, quick, tell me the prerequisites for Computer 272. Paper is still involved in the planning. And so MacEwan has made an effort to actually try and fix this by creating the online schedule planner. It's really efficient for scheduling your courses, but is it efficient for planning your courses? And to be honest with you, I haven't really used it that much or at all. Everyone has their own way of planning their degree. These are just three ways you could plan your MacEwan degree, but in the end, they end up being inefficient and taking up too much time. The current ways to plan your degree works, but we decided to find a better solution because planning courses is something we shouldn't have to suffer through. It should be like learning how to walk. It's a one-time struggle, and after a couple years, it's easy. It comes naturally, and we don't even have to think about it. That's why we started this project, the MacEwan Computer Science Degree Planner. From interviewing fellow classmates and fellow university friends, we researched the most common things that university students look for when they're planning for their degree. When you first open up the new MacEwan Degree Planner, a Getting Started modal will appear. This onboarding helps unfamiliar users to familiarize themselves with the application. So here are the things that students usually look for when planning a MacEwan degree. First, they want to always have the information available on the courses. What the name is, how many credits, the course description, and its prerequisites. Here we made a feature where you could search through all the computer science courses by ID, course name, and even the course's description. And while you're typing, the results will update. To get this dataset, we web scraped MacEwan's academic calendar. We used two Python libraries to web scrape. We used import requests and beautiful soup. We used import requests to get data from a URL, and then we used beautiful soup to parse the HTML. Another important part of this column is the mark the selected courses. So this is basically a multi-select dropdown where you could choose the courses you want to update into your table or add. There's also a choice to remove from the table just in case you want to remove a lot of courses at once. Here you can also import a CSV file. And then at the very bottom, there is the change view. This is where a user can choose between the table view and the sunburst view. didn't have enough time to implement this, but in the future, we would like to have this so that students can see the relation between the courses they have in their table visually. The second thing that students are always looking for when planning is what they have done, what they have planned, and what they're currently in. So as we saw before, anything you update through the mark selected courses will update the table. Here you can see the course ID, the number of credits it has, and its prerequisites. You can export your table as a CSV file by clicking the export button at the top. The creation of the data table relies heavily on the built-component data table. By using a template used in Plotly-'s documentation with data tables, we were able to implement a filter search inside the data table. The data table offers two different types of input, the first one being numbers, like integers or floats, but you only see that in the credits column. The one that is the most relevant is searching by text or string. Within Dash's data table filtering system, there's already a documentation on how to filter, and these are just some of the examples of how you could search in those inputs. At the bottom, you have three buttons. The first one is the Getting Started button. This is where you can see the onboarding modal again. So whenever you get lost or don't know what something does, you could go back to it. The other two buttons are instructions. The first one is teaching you how to import a CSV file. Because there is a specific formatting to the CSV file, it has to be exact in some places of the CSV so that it can actually implement properly into the table. And the other button is how to read the prerequisites and how it's organized. In the future, we really want to implement this in a more visual way by using color and design principles. To go over what we've just talked about, there are three main things that we look for when planning our MacEwan student degree plan. The first one being is a list of courses available or we need to take, and having that information available to us readily. The second thing that we look for is what we have already taken, so personalized to us. Now, the third thing that we look for is a checklist of things to make sure that we have everything and to make sure that we're on our way to graduate on time or at least graduating. And so that leads us to the final column. This is a checklist for a computer science major. Right under the title, you see a dropdown that has a placeholder saying choose a stream. So whenever you choose a stream, it updates your checklist to match with your stream. Now, we didn't get to implement features and interactiveness with this column, but in the future, we would really like it if a student updates the table, it would reflect on the checklist automatically. Our application aims to help students to become more efficient and to just be less stressed when it comes time to almost graduate or even during your years in university. By ideizing and creating solutions for the problem, we can put our valuable time into more relevant things or things that are higher in our priority, which is great because now we'll have more time to stress about our assignments rather than worrying about both.